Shalom, this is another day that the Lord has made, and I know that we shall be glad and we shall always rejoice in this. It is a joy for me to always come before your presence again just to bring you a simple word of truth that will always benefit us. At this particular time, I am concerned about a lot of people that I have heard, I have talked to, the people that I have visited, those who are going through a lot of problems, those who are in a lot of lack, including men of God and even the people who are Christians, and most of them are wondering what is going on. So today I want to bring us an encouragement that God shall supply all your need according to his riches in glory, because he is the God who supplies unto us. This is a scripture that comes from the book of Philippians, chapter 4 and verse 13. And the Bible says, "And my God," Paul writes and says, "my God shall supply all your needs according to his riches in glory." When Paul is writing this, he is writing to a church who has sacrificed everything to benefit the kingdom duty, the kingdom work, working in the vineyard, supporting Paul in his work of ministry. So Paul gives a prayer unto them, which is an encouragement to all of us, a confirmation of the Spirit that our God always desires to answer our prayers every time that we call unto him. And whatever labor of love that we have done, it will never go in vain. That whatever we do for the kingdom of God shall not go in vain. Many of you have worked and served in the kingdom of God. And now in this very pandemic, you are going through a very tough time and you're asking yourself, where is God? Now, this scripture in reading, and we have used it many, many, many times before, and always we are using it as a scripture of God bringing abundance and God bringing prosperity and making us rich in an overflow. But let us consider it at this point, or from the readings of the Bible that I have done. All the versions say God shall supply. The choice of words here is very interesting. The word supply is very different from the word give or even provide. The word supply means to fill in the gap of the missing areas of your provision. It is to provide for a need and a want, not only that, but in a large quantity over a given time. It is consistent. There is a consistency in supply. I will give us a very simple, simple illustration. When you are asked to supply an institution with merchandise or some goods or services, when you supply, you have to sit down, plan, and know what you are supplying over a period of time, so that as you supply this, there will be no lack. Every time the supply goes down, you will be asked to supply even more. So even God, when we are reading this, it calls to mind what happened in the Bible days. Elijah, he was fed by the ravens. Elijah went to a widow who had nothing. They just had a little oil and they had a little flour. And Elijah asked this woman to make him a little bread first. And the woman said, "As the Lord lives, I only have this to eat with my son and die." So you see, but over the period of 3.5 years after the obedience of this woman, the Lord supplied her provision. She never lacked. Again, we see a widow in the times of Elisha who has a little oil with a very great debt. So God comes in his own specific way and supplies the need. Borrowed from her neighbors, she filled and there was no bottle left. The essence of supply, we see it in the New Testament where Jesus, our Lord and Savior, says he wants to feed 5,000 people using 2 little fish and 5 loaves of bread. That is the idea of supply. So these people are poor and they have supported Paul through their pastor. They have supported Paul in his ministry. Though Paul says, "I can do all things through Christ who strengthens me," meaning he can continue in the service of the Lord whether he has much or he has less. But these people choose that they have to serve the Lord and they send their pastor over to provide, give them an abundance of an overflow but it is a prayer that God would meet them at their point of need. That every area where there is a hole, every area where there is a vacuum, every area where there is lack, that God in His own way would provide. Many other preachers will tell you this, that when you give unto God, He will give you 100%. They tell you to send 10 shillings, then you will receive 100 shillings. They tell you to give, for example, 100,000 shillings for the ministry, and God will refund you with 1,000,000. That is not the mathematics of God. God's ways are not our ways. And therefore, when God says He shall supply all our needs according to His riches in glory, He means He shall fill in every need. He shall meet every need as they arise in your life. So these people are poor, but Paul is confident that they will not lack, because God is no one's debtor. God does not take anyone's thing. You can't lend to God and God fails to give back. God is faithful. He says, test me in this and see if I will not open the doors of the world. My God shall complete in large provisions over a period of time, according provide for your needs according to His riches in glory. When He talks about need, God provides our need, not according to our request, but according to His riches in glory that are in Christ Jesus. This is very important for us to understand. The provision of God is not dependent on our lack. The provision and the goodness and the faithful of God does not depend on how much we need. It doesn't depend on the variety of needs that we have in the house. Our mortgages, maybe our school fees, maybe you have to buy a car, maybe you have to find transportation provision, you have provision for food, your provision for all these things that we need and the bills that we have in the house. God does not provide according to our bills. God provides according to His riches in glory, which are in Christ Jesus. The richness and the glorious abundance of God is opened to us when we decide to serve the kingdom with our substance. At this particular time, let me try to remember all pastors and ask them a question, all men of God, and ask them this simple question. Are you confident to call on to your members and tell them, and my God, Paul had a very specific and personal relationship, a confident relationship with God the Father. And therefore he said, my God shall supply. He said, my God shall supply. He is confident God will supply all the needs of those people who provide for them according to His riches in glory. So we must have a personal relationship even in our houses. We need to have this personal relationship whereby you can bless your wife and say, my wife and my God shall supply. You need to bless your parents and say, my God shall supply. You need to bless your children and say, my God shall supply. Even your parents, bless them and say, my God shall supply all your needs according to His riches in glory. This confidence that God, and many people, yes, many people are in need, but God knows our very need even before we ask them. So whenever we partner with the kingdom duty and the kingdom work, God opens His window and He provides for each one who has served in that ministry. Even now, at this particular time, you can try and serve with the ministry. Remember your men of God. Remember your pastors. Remember your apostles and your prophets wherever they are. Remember them in this time. Maybe they don't have anything in their houses. Remember them and God will surely remember you. I didn't say you send to me. Send to your pastors, to the people out there that are working, are in the labor of love for the sake of the kingdom. God knows our need. And when we ask, Jesus always wants us to be able to ask Him. Ask Him and it shall be given, that God the Father may be glorified in the Son. Ask and you will receive, that your joy may be full. That is what the Bible says. And then when we have asked, when we have served, then God shall supply all our need according to His riches in glory. The riches of God are the valuable bestowment and the glorious abundance that are in Christ Jesus. Now, this is very important. We know that our God is a God who has no partiality. He sends his rain both to the righteous and to the unrighteous. That bit is very true. But this particular blessing is not for every person. This particular blessing is for people who have decided to serve the gospel of Jesus Christ. He says, these glorious riches are not in any other personality, and not in any other mediator, and not in any other personality. They are in Jesus Christ, and therefore you have to serve God in Jesus Christ. All this bestowment, all these glorious riches, they are inside Jesus Christ. And therefore, when we get into Jesus, we can access them. Not getting into Jesus and sitting there, but getting into Jesus and serving the kingdom duty. And therefore, God and Jesus Christ will release the abundance of his riches unto our lives. That means you will not lack in your house. Yes, you will not lack in your house. In anything that you're facing, yes, you may be receiving just enough, like the people receive the manna, but it will never run out until a time comes where God will now bring the increase and the abundance of the overflow. But we need to be faithful in serving the kingdom, even right now. Thank you for listening. I am Ticha Masai. God bless you. Shalom.